the exterior stuff that happens up in space is what ILM's doing. And we're also involved in the opening sequence where they're almost in space in the during the X2 flight.
Frank! Look at that. That's where we're going. I don't know how, and I don't know when, but fly to the moon and let me play among the stars. Oh, come on, baby, come on.
The X2 flight in the opening sequence of the movie is back in time, black and white. It's telling us about our characters before they got to the space program. And it tells us about their characters. And it all happens within a very short flight where they go up into the outer stratosphere. And it sort of introduces us to their character, but also into the sort of the problems that they have in their flights and their personalities, which sort of echo back later on in the movie. In real space, during their space flights, they run into similar situations.
Boys look mighty sharp.
When we do film for a spacesuit, when you do film for anything, you have things that are more than real and things that are less than real. An answering machine has to be built that's more than real, because you have to be able to control the lights to go on and off and do things that it normally wouldn't do. But it's less than real because it doesn't really answer the phone. In a spacesuit, the same sort of thing. It's less than real because it doesn't support your life in space, but it's more than real because it has to do things. Things have to light up, switches have to go on and off or be easy to reach, and things that we have to make it convenient for the actors. Our suits have the exact same outer fabric. It's called ortho fabric. It's woven Teflon. See, it's nice because you can cook muffins on them and they don't stick. All of the controls, all of the proportions, everything is almost to blueprint. Matter of fact, some of our pieces could interchange with the real components. They're that accurate. They're considerably lighter because we don't have the life support systems in them, but generally they're visually and dimensionally right on the money. The amount of time it takes to do these is just astronomical. I mean, it takes a tremendous amount of time in all the details. I think just in the fabric, there are over 100 patterns. Clint's been great because he really wanted detail, and Deborah Hopper, the costume designer, really wanted detail. There are some aerospace guys out there that would look at it and go, hey, wow, look at that, that's right. And when I meet those guys, that makes me feel good, that they can sit with their family and go, hey, look at, you see, boy, they got that right, instead of what they normally do, okay, it's a movie. So that's nice.
What ILM has done is set the pace for the exterior shots in space is we have a bunch of miniatures. This is a miniature of the opening sequence of the X2, but we built a lot of miniatures as in the shuttle and other space vehicles up there. We photograph as objective views, and then we're cutting in stage elements, meaning we shot the interior of the cockpit and we cut that into the interior of our miniatures so that they're sort of incorporated and it looks like everybody's there. As an example of how we put the visuals into a scene, for example, if there's a shot of the shuttle up in space and there's an interior shot of the guys, you cut to the outside and you see the big shuttle and you see the guys inside the cockpit, you can see them through the windows. What we end up doing is we photograph a large miniature of the shuttle in front of a blue screen. It's so we can extract the model out of the image. And we also develop a star field, and we put that behind the photographed miniature of the shuttle. But it's composited together so that the shuttle by itself, then you've got a star field behind it that we develop, and then we take an image that we photographed of the guys on the set who are in the cockpit, and we put them image-wise into the cockpit of the shuttle. So you've got these relatively three elements. You've got the shuttle, you've got a starfield, and then you've got the guys inside the cockpit. And that's generically how we do most shots. Granted, some things get far more complicated. There's a few more details to all this stuff. But in a simple form, that's really what happens. We did an animatic, what we call an animatic, which is a sort of a mock-up, sort of low-tech version of the movie, sort of like an animation. And in doing this, we scripted it out and whatnot, and then Clint could take a look at this stuff and see what was working, what was not working. Inclusive of that concept in this animatic, because we basically did an animatic for the last quarter of the movie while they're in space. And in doing that, it's sort of like a storyboard, but it's in motion. And in doing that, we also worked out the sort of lighting diagram of where we are in space, what time of day this is, or what time in space it is. Is the sun up? Is the moon up? What works dramatically timing-wise with the different light schemes? Then after this was approved and Clint liked what we were doing, I went over this with the director photographer, Jack Green, and just said, okay, is this going to work for you on your sets and whatnot? Because we certainly had to collaborate on how we were going to approach this stuff. And so we came up with a scheme of how and when things happen timing-wise, either where everything's moving in space, or what the sun was doing, what the moon was doing, what time of day it was. And it just all a little choreography and understanding. As long as all of us knew what was supposed to happen, then everything should work out just fine. Most things that we do visual effects-wise are always unusual, but it's just a puzzle. Square pegs and round holes, things like that.